Don't be so humble. You are not that great. Right? So I'm not that great. But try and make up. So I've got a presentation for you. And it's always lovely to be back with young students like you, which makes you at least 18 years younger. Right? Right? So I'm a guy with 18 years experience, but 22 years of age. That makes me 40.
Okay. So let me change the... Can I have a mic? So can we have a round of applause for yourself, please?
I clicked some photographs, right? I wanted to keep the memory and see what I got. Wow. Oh. Sorry, I got it wrong. But you know, more than you, I think I'm happy to be here today. And this is me. Right? Looks like me? Right? Oh, that's also wrong, huh? Okay. So let's move ahead. So as you have introduced, I'm a very young guy, almost 40 now. And of course, after looking at Dr. Khandal, only thing I could remember was Umar Pachpan Ka Dil Bachpan Ka Sir. Right? Amazing, amazing. So I'm a graduate from Sir Xavier, Kolkata, and I actually, he is happy, I'm happy too. So I did my PhD before MBA, sir. Right, so I actually did my PhD before MBA. Anybody asking why? How? So I actually passed high school with difficulty. That's PhD. That's why I can did my MBA. So that's PhD for me. But I want to do PhD later on in my life. So I have worked in Singapore, Australia, Dubai, South Africa, blah, blah, blah. And almost out of 15 years. And when I joined my MBA classes 1996, right? Before I could get a job, I found my soulmate there. So I'm married to a girl who was my batchmate. Right? And she's also in teaching, and we have got two kids.
Give a big hand to it for this.
Yeah. I was very clear.
So you had a purpose doing MBA.
Yeah, of course. But life has been wonderful, right? So just a small story. I lost my dad when I was actually doing my MBA first year. I've got three sisters, all younger to me. And I had to continue my studies. My mom is a teacher, school teacher. But she told me that you go ahead and do it. So from there on, I never looked. I was the first one to get a job out of my MBA college way back in 1996. 97, that was 22nd of December. Last 15 years, it has been a great journey with companies like HCL, and that's where I met Deepak also. Deepak was sitting, and from IBM, we worked together in HCL. Then I worked for Birlasoft, then IBM also, I worked for a very, very small period. And then I'm working for Samsung for almost 2 years now. So I have done a lot of HR stuff, but now I'm getting into a lot of other things also. Yes, this is what I do. So being in HR is actually fun, huh? So this is what I do apart from HR. Okay. So any guesses from which part of the country I am? No. So there's only one. After United States of America, there's United States of Bihar. Okay. So I belong to a place called Patna, and I'm from United States of Bihar. Okay. So let me just take you through. Now I'll present to you something that you know. Who are these people? Just keep naming them. Right. So what's common between all these people? How many have seen Chennai Express? Don't underestimate the power of common man. These are all common man. They are all ordinary people who did extraordinary job. You agree?
Yes.
We are all ordinary people. But we have the capability and ability to do extraordinary job. And all because of your hard work, all because of your dreaming that you can do and chase those dreams. Right? So I'll pause for a minute and I'll show you a video which talks about how ordinary people have glorified themselves and done extraordinary work. Okay? So here's a video for you. Yeah. तो माइक लगा दे। क्या हुआ यार? You go back. So there is a course, there will be professors who will come and teach you, but all the legwork, all the hard work you will have to do, and you will have to find that magical genie which can make you successful, and that will only happen through hard work. Okay, so how many of you know this guy Robert Kiyosaki? Anybody has read his book called Rich Dad Poor Dad? He is a second generation American Japanese, and he is a great motivator, speaker, and a writer. So what he says is, when you are young, work to learn, not to earn. But most of the times we actually look at it differently, diagonally opposite. We want to earn, we want to learn to earn. So when you actually enter after 3 years, when you enter corporate, find ways to learn as much as possible for the first 5 years or 7 years. And then there will be no looking back, right? When you are young, work to learn, not to earn. Very amazing thing which Alvin Toffler has said, currently, if you are not unlearning things which you have learned in the past, then you will be an illiterate. Because the rate of change of things which are happening in technology, in social world, in economy, everywhere, is so fast paced that if you don't keep tab of that changes, you will be called an illiterate. So what he says is, the illiterate of 21st century will not be those who cannot read or write, but those who cannot learn, unlearn, and relearn. Right? And that's where the generation gap comes. Not because we wear pants here and you wear it here, that's the generation gap. It doesn't happen, right? Okay, so I've got a video here, but the voice is not required to show how things you can learn and then apply for your own benefit. And that's in 2010, this was a Pepsi ad. Facilities, are you going and asking questions, the right question from the professors and learning from your seniors, whether they are in the industry or not? Time will fly and suddenly one day you will be sitting here for your convocation and then you realize if you had learned or if your marks were such and such, you would have landed in a better job. So always remember that you are the one who will navigate your time. Find time to read, find time to network and do the best as you can. In the middle of the problem, always comes an opportunity. So people say that whenever there is a problem, there is an opportunity. Okay, and we have to find that opportunity for ourselves rather than going and telling it's not going to happen. Okay, so I'll show you another video. Don't put the sound there. Okay, which talks about how you can change the problems into an opportunity. Okay. Guilt, some kind of things that you've come because you've studied in different schools and you're coming from different places. But now that you're all equal in IMS and you're looking for a job, you'll have to release your brain and you'll have to unleash your potential in whatever form. And everything you want is just outside your comfort zone is the message that I want to give. So if you think that you're doing this much, which will fetch you 70%, go outside your comfort zone. Take that leap. Make yourself uncomfortable. Then only you will get to that 100%, 110%, 120%. And you will unleash your potential. Okay. This is something, in my opinion, the most voiced, powerful and neglected secret to success and happiness. People don't ask it. Of course, men are wired not to ask. Most of the cases. When we actually lose our ways and are going with wife will say, can you ask that guy? You'll say, no, I can find him. Right? Because men are from Mars, women are from Venus. We don't ask. But who's told you not to ask? Please go. Approach people who can give you an answer, who can tell you where you can find a solution and increase your knowledge. Right? And prepare yourself for the future. So I want to give because most of the people have fear. And you've got two choices. Forget everything and run. Or face everything and rise. Choice is always yours. And always, most of the successful people will always choose and go and work out a solution and be successful. All the successful people in this world have very sad stories, very difficult stories. But one thing that they have in common is they have got a beautiful ending. You agree?
Yes, sir.
So no choice or nothing is there to go back because we can't go back in time and change a bad start. But we can always start now and create a beautiful ending. It doesn't matter where you start, but it always matter where you finish. So have you finished strong? So I'll let you know. Okay. So many people die with their music still in them. This is one of my favorite saying, right? People want to say, ye karna chahta tha, ye kar leta. Who stopped you? Please go ahead and do. Go ahead and live your dream. For whatever you've come to IMS and whatever you want to achieve in life, please do that. And you have to start now. Do your job as a student, be strong in fundamentals. Because fundamentals are the ones, if you are strong at, it will lead ways to do a lot of things, a lot of innovation. Read beyond your textbooks. Do projects, get involved, participate in extracurricular activities. Develop social skills. Because currently, if you are not wired on Facebook, Twitter, and you are not socially networked, that's considered not good in today's society. So you have to be networked. Develop your social quotient, right? Improve your communication skills, network, and keep the end in the mind. And because you're all NCA students, I've got a very small successful mantra, control alt del. You just have to control yourself, right? Always look for alternative solutions, and of course, delete all the things that gives you control alt del. That is for you. So let me very quickly tell you what has been and how I have been successful in my life. In last 15 years, I have got 8 promotions. Every 2 years, 1.5 years, I get promotion. Always because I'm dedicated, focused, and never let other things come to mind when it comes to work. And I'm always innovative, right? So these are some things that I've never... Only shortcut that I know is the long way, which is hard work. Luck is when preparation meets opportunity. And Oprah Winfrey also talks a lot about a preparation and opportunity. Make mistakes, but don't repeat them. No work is useless. You learn something useful out of it. Networking helps. Reading is absolutely mandatory. If you're not reading, you'll be dead very soon. Having the right attitude decides your altitude. Winning is not everything because there'll be a lot of competition that you'll get into, but the effort to win is. Because there will always be a huge learning.